Okay, this is something that I don't usually show in any process videos because it's really boring and I don't do it that often. But sometimes when these things get out of control, I just have to go in. This is oleo gel. I'm trying to use this instead of thinner because I need some pretty dark lines. Sometimes when they get out of control like this, you kind of have to just go back into it and redefine, you know, the important lines in it, which I've lost them in this one. There's some things going on. Some things going on that I like, but as far as having to establish, as far as the piece holding together, I've got to reestablish what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to fight the urge because I'm like right now I want to darken that in, but I'm trying to just to work on nothing but lines. So when I come back in after these lines are dried, when I come back in and work on them, if I mess up, then the lines will still be established underneath, so I can see, you know, I can see where I, if I go wrong, I can wipe it off and keep going. Some of these lines aren't that important. I'm just re-emphasizing stuff, but some are pretty important. Like this issue, this space in here is really, really hard for me because it's supposed to be in almost total darkness. So I've got to decide, I mean, this is really what I don't want to do, but I can't help it. I'm trying to decide where the lines are going to show and where the edges are just going to be completely lost. And it's really hard. It's really hard to do working out of your imagination, which is, you know, which is what I tend to do, what I always do. In this area, like, it's a big mass, and I want it to be, you know, blown out because there's a strong light source behind there, and I don't think you can see any details, really. But still, I have to. Unless it's going to be a complete blur, I have to figure out a few spots where they're going to be edges or where the form's going to be. This stuff on the bottom is pretty well established, and it's so white that I don't really want to go back and do a whole lot because I want it to be white. It's supposed to be blown out from the overhead fluorescent lights. It's kind of what I wanted to show with this piece was just the thought of giving birth in a hospital and how bright and sanitized everything is. And it's partially from memory. That's why there's a sort of mood. That's why there's a sort of mood to it. It wasn't really a wonderful experience on my part. Gone into it in detail before, but I'm not really going to get into it now. So sometimes you just have to go in, and even though these lines may not show as lines in the finished piece, you know, all I used for these was just a red and a black. I try not to use straight black ever, just because there's really no use for it, because there's not really much real black ever in reality. Not that I paint reality all the time, but it's usually related. There's a few more minutes. If I had more time, I would go in and darken some spaces and define them that way. I said, I'm really just trying to get, and I'm sorry if I can't catch all these, I'm not really moving the phone around enough, I guess. What's that? Couldn't help that, I was supposed to do that. Should have gone online, but I was kind of carried away. There were little spots where these, like, the hands here are going to disappear in the shadow. And I've got to. I said, it's just so when I go back in, I have something to go by. Kind of a map of what I wanted to find when I go back in. Some of this, like I said, won't show. But all this, I don't even know how I'm going to approach this yet, because all this is so white. It's coming from behind her that she's not going to have much contrast, because if you were looking at a bright light, you wouldn't be able to read her face that well. So all the dark's going to be down here, but still, you've got to have something to work with. Your eye would, even if you could see it, your eye would make up the details. Like all this here is, I'm not putting lines in that because I don't want it to be lines. I want it to be where the light is kind of blinding on those edges. And this isn't the kind of line work where I would go back in and do some, you know, directional stuff. I don't really want to get into all that. I'm just trying to figure out what's going on in the piece. Starting to sit, like, this line is not going to be there, but I'm trying to draw where the bright spot is going to, plane is going to receive all the light, it's going to be right there. All right, now.